Yo, 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 what is good, YouTube? Welcome back to the channel, and I got a new game review for y'all. A couple weeks old now at this point, but you know what I'm saying? I had to give it enough time to really get the feel of what the game was. But the game I'm talking about is the Avengers game. I've been playing it for a while now, pretty much since launch day. I got it the first day it came out, and I even played the beta. So I feel like I've played enough to where I can give you guys a decent review. Now, I'm not at level cap. Level cap is 150. I'm only like 120 maybe. So forgive me for that. But at this current point in time, there really is no in-game to be at level cap for. And I have definitely experienced all of the content that the game has to offer, short of obviously like leveling up every single character. So whether this is going to be an impressions or a review for you, I'll let y'all decide that. But I'm going to call it a review. And I broke down some pros and cons here that I'm just kind of going to talk to. Not really too much structure to this. It's going to be a little bit casual. So I'm hoping y'all can, you know what I'm saying, take a seat, relax, enjoy, and see what I have to say. So first of all, pros. Let's start with the pros. Let's start with the good things first. Lead with positivity. The first notable thing is that the combat is really fun. And I think with this type of loot-based game, for those of you who don't know, this is essentially like a Destiny clone with an Avengers skin on it. And I don't say that to be reductive because I love Destiny, but it is a heavily loot-based RPG light kind of game. Like, there are light RPG mechanics in there, such as leveling up and progression. But the core of the game is that loot treadmill. You're chasing better and better and better loot by doing repeatable activities in order to get to the level cap. And hopefully at some point in the near future, you will be able to do some type of challenging in-game cooperative or even solo activity, but some type of challenging in-game that all of this leveling and grinding will pay off for. So I think with this type of game, the main thing to nail is the combat. I'm gonna be using probably Destiny and like Anthem as examples a lot in this video, because this game is very close to those games. And I think the thing that kept people coming back to those games was that the combat loop was just so super satisfying. Just the act of, if it's a shooter, the act of pulling the trigger, you know, movement, killing enemies, how satisfying and rewarding does that feel in itself if you even strip away everything else about the game? I think that's very important, and I think this game does a pretty good job of that. I think when you're playing with the various superheroes, you feel pretty super. Hits are pretty weighty, especially when you have that controller vibration turned on. You can feel the impact of each hit. Like, you feel like you're really doing damage to these enemies, even though they're robots. But we'll talk about that later in the cons. But overall, I think the combat is really fun. I play mainly as Thor, and I think they did a good job of him feeling like a real god, which is, I think, important. I think flight is a thing that they nailed. The fact that they nailed flying so well, like, it feels slightly worse than Anthem flying, if anybody's familiar with that, but that's not a bad knock at all. Like, it's completely feels good to fly around, to the point where I don't really want to play as characters that can't fly anymore, just because it's such a fun and free and liberating method of movement to me. Like, it to me is the superior form of movement in any game that allows you to actually fly. So, you know, that's really cool. And it also makes me wonder, like, how it's always been so hard, or I guess they've only tried once, but how it was so hard to make a Superman game that was fun when you have these games where the character can fly, and so many developers do a good job with it nowadays. But that's a bit of a tangent. Building on top of the combat, the RPG progression system in the game, while I don't know how necessary it was, like, I don't know that if it wasn't there, how much less I would enjoy the game, but I do know that it doesn't feel unnecessary either. Like, it doesn't feel tacked on. It feels like they put enough thought into it. There's some substantial abilities, fun to use abilities in that progression tree. And the progression in this game, it isn't a typical like full-on RPG where you have, you know, really builds. Now, you do have light builds. Like, you have a couple selectable perk options where, like, I don't know, one perk, for example, on your ultimate, one perk will give you extra ice damage on your ultimate, and as opposed to healing, and you have to choose between those two to use on your ultimate. And you can kind of see how you can have kind of light builds in game, kind of similar again to like Destiny, Anthem, stuff like that, where you don't necessarily have to choose your skill points carefully because you have everything available to you once you fully level up your character. And I think that's kind of just a personal preference thing. Like, do you prefer to be locked out of abilities and have to have that feeling of commitment more? Or do you actually just want to have the freedom to choose and hot swap everything and try out different builds on the fly whenever you want? If you're the latter, then this game will be good for you because it has that freedom. You can, you know, spec out even during a mission if you want. Like, in the middle of combat, you can switch your build around if you want. And then a great selection of cosmetics I have is another pro for this game. So I think with any comic book based game like this, that's drawing from such a large pool of existing media, obviously that being the comic books, you have to utilize that to your advantage. So a game like this, especially if they're trying to put in microtransactions, you have to have something to chase. So the gear itself does not reflect on your character's appearance, which that is kind of one of my cons as well, but the cosmetics do, like this character skins do, are the only thing that really affect the appearance of your character. And I think it's important for those skins to be really dope, and I think, you know, I think they did a good job of making those skins dope. Like, each character has a cool amount of skins. You know, Thor has from very basic skins to old school skins drawn from like, or pulled from like classic comics and stuff like that. And then they have the very regal, kind of kingly, powerful looking skin. So it's kind of something for everybody. They have the more jokey, like Hulk in a tank top, like wife beater type skin and gym shorts or something like that. So they do have fun with it. And I really like that. I really, really, really love when games don't take themselves too seriously, especially games based on comic books, because comics are known for not taking themselves too seriously. So kudos on the cosmetics. I really like the cosmetics selection here. My last pro, a point that I was actually surprised about when I played the game, is that the single player story, along with the cutscenes in the single player story, were actually pretty good. And like, to the point where for this type of loot based game, I think I can probably say that Avengers may have the best in-game story. Now, I'm just talking about in-game story. I'm not talking about lore, because obviously the lore is just the Marvel the Marvel comic book universe would be the lore. And if you like the lore of that, then it's just a matter of whether you like Marvel comics and Marvel comic characters, or even the Marvel Cinematic Universe characters. Destiny, I think, started that trend of the lore being really good, but the story in-game, like the game you play through in single player, the cutscenes and stuff like that, were super lacking in Destiny. So, and pretty much Division, every loot-based game, Anthem like this, had a poor single player story. But this game, I think, does a good job. The cutscenes are good. The story is well-paced. I think the take on it, on Kamala Khan as the main character, you kind of feel, or at least I kind of felt, as if I was watching a Marvel intro movie that was the introduction to Kamala Khan as a character. So that was really good. I feel like they could repurpose these cutscenes as a movie if they just, you know, use real actors. And this could be the Kamala Khan cinematic universe story arc. And I think that's really good that they managed to fit that in the game. And not only that, but just a small shout out to the fact that you can play this game completely offline, completely solo. While you will have AI teammates taking control of your partners for you, it's just nice to be able to pause a loot-based game like this. Like, that's such a breath of fresh air. Like, normally you can't even pause a game like this because you constantly have to be connected to the internet. But it's just awesome to be able to play completely solo and have that option for when I want to play completely solo. Alright, so now that the pros are out of the way, and I can actually say there are more pros than cons, now we're into the cons. So the first and probably the biggest con is that this game is one of the most repetitive games I've ever played, and that is due to the level design and the enemy design. So the enemies are all these super generic robots or no-face dudes in hazmat suits. AIM is the main kind of antagonist entity in the game, and I know why they do that. It's because it's Marvel, it's got to be PG 13 essentially, so the enemies, there can't be blood, they can't be too violent, so that super takes away from a lot of the immersion, I think, when you're just beating up on dummy robots. Even though the combat itself feels satisfying, it doesn't feel like you're really fighting any, it feels like you're fighting toys, essentially. Like, it feels like you're fighting faceless toys that don't matter in the grand scheme of things. And I think they just could have done a really, really much better job with the enemy design. Again, back to the Destiny comparison, I think the Destiny aliens are designed so much better. And that is another game that is kind of PG-13, but they do it just in a much better way. The enemies have faces, the enemies kind of have personalities. In this game, the enemies just really have no personality aside from the obvious comic book villains that are very few and far between. So that is something I think could use extreme improvement. And then the matchmaking. I think the matchmaking was not fully thought out. So if you have a squad of four people, and on that squad of four people, only one person can be any one hero. So you can't have any duplicate heroes. You can't have two Iron Mans. You can't have two Thors. You can't have two Hulks. You have to, everybody has to be their own hero. But the way the leveling system works, where each hero is leveled independently, you want to go in with your favorite hero. I'll use myself as an example. I want to go in and play as Thor, but Thor might be a popular hero. So if other people want to go in and play as Thor, it's going to take me so much longer in matchmaking to find a match where people are willing to play as someone other than Thor. So most of the time, if I don't have friends online with this game, I'm literally just playing by myself. And that's fine for me, but I know for a lot of people, they want to be able to matchmake and hop online easily and get a quick game with randoms, you know, if they don't have a lot of friends online all the time. So it just kind of sucks that they put that restriction in. I don't really think it needs to be there, especially seeing that this is an already over-the-top comic book game. I don't see why it's an issue that, you know, multiple characters, like, people can pick duplicate characters. And there is really no teamwork incentive to picking different characters as well. Like, yeah, some characters like Kamala can heal, you know, Captain America can tank, but it really, there are no defined roles in this game, so you really don't need to be restricted to the typical class system of an MMO. Like, you could definitely just go in as four Thors and it'd be just as fun a game. You know, you could crank up the difficulty, it would still be challenging. I don't think it breaks anything. So I really hope this is a choice that they take another look at going forward. Like, they've been really good about updating the game and listening to the community, but I really hope that they, you know, dial back that restriction, and I think as a result it will also improve the matchmaking. And then the last and final con of the game, it's not too bad, but I did experience a lot of bugs in my playthrough, and I know I'm not the only one, because Square and Crystal Dynamics actually issued an apology and gave in-game items as a result of all the bugs. Like, and they are fixing them, don't get me wrong, but it's just so frustrating to me when I'm going through a game and either my PlayStation blue screens or I run into some random in-game game breaking bug where I have to quit the entire mission, close the entire app, and I lose all that progress. Like, progress losing bugs are the worst kind of bugs, and this game had a lot. Maybe four or five times through the not very long single player campaign, I had to literally restart a mission, restart my entire game, and go back in progress just because of some NPC didn't spawn right, or some enemy was stuck in a wall in game. You know, stuff like that just kind of gets really annoying. And that's in addition to a bunch of visual glitches, like Thor's hammer will glitch out, his lightning will glitch out, characters will get stuck in animations, just little stuff like that. Like, you can tell the game was kind of rushed in some aspects and a lot of things weren't tested well, but I don't always put that on the developer so much so as I do the publisher, because, you know, obviously they're trying to hit dates and make money. So, I mean, what can you really do? It didn't really stop me from playing the game. Like I said, I got pretty much to end game now. I only have a few more levels to go before I'm level cap. Hopefully they'll drop the raid soon. I don't know if I'll make an updated video when they do drop the raids, but I don't know, maybe I'll tweet about it or something. So follow me on there if you want to hear. But that's kind of it for this review. I really do like the game. I think it's both different and what I expected. I think it's a unique game. I think it's a good first attempt at an Avengers game. I don't know if it'll be the last. And I'm actually just really curious to see how they improve it, because this game is heavily marketed as a games of service game, and it seems like it's going to be going on for a while. So really curious to see what happens with it. Let me know what y'all think of this game in the comments below. Let me know who y'all favorite hero is in the game. If you saw those hero leaks, let me know what upcoming hero you're excited for, or who you want them to put into the game. You know, let me know all that stuff down in the comments. And as always, I really appreciate y'all for watching. Leave a thumbs up if you liked it, subscribe if you want to see more, and I will catch y'all in the next video. Peace out.